Hey guys, Silver81 here again. Hey, I wanted to do a quick video about something I see going on eBay a lot and some other online websites. These guys selling junk silver lots, US pre-65 junk silver lots, and they're not being completely honest with people, and I'm seeing people way overpay for these lots, and it's kind of bordering on a big ripoff as far as I'm concerned with a lot of these lots. And one of the two main things that they're not disclosing or putting it in the fine print way down low somewhere is the lots consist of a big pile of silver war nickels, and they're pretty hefty, but they're only 35% silver. They were made during the war years, and they make up a large portion of the lot, usually more than half. And you know, they're selling it as pre-65 US junk silver, and you know, it's true, it is pre-65 US junk silver, but they know what they're doing, and basically they're just scamming people. War nickels are easy to identify. They have the big mint mark right there above the Monticello in the back. You know, it's either a PD or S. You know, of course they have the standard front with Jefferson, but they have the big mint mark there on the back. So those are the only nickels that had that big giant mint mark, and they are worth about $1 a piece or 94 cents, but you know, for their weight, you're only getting 35% silver. Now, another thing I'm seeing is they're putting 40% Kennedy halves in these piles. The only Kennedy half that's 90% silver is the 1964. For general circulation, that is. The 1964. So the 1965 through 1970, they were 40% silver. Now, there were some mint issues later on, proof issues that, you know, were 90% silver, but those weren't produced for general circulation. So those are the two things. Another thing, they're selling it by the pound or by the ounce. Now, is that a avoirdupois ounce? I think that's the way you pronounce it, avoirdupois or troy, because bullion is sold as a troy ounce, which is 31.1 grams or something like that. And a avoirdupois ounce is a little over 28 grams. I think it's 28.3. You know, big difference, you know, about a 3 gram difference per ounce. And if they're selling it as a regular pound, you know, a avoirdupois pound, which is how you weigh carrots or, you know, groceries or meat, or are they selling it by a troy pound, which is how you weigh bullion, and it's heavier. So, you know, that's another thing to watch out for. You can go to coinflation.com. I'll leave a link below, and it'll tell you the exact silver value of the junk silver that you're buying. But right now, with silver at the current spot price of about $16.70, generally a good rule of thumb is between 12 and 14 times face value for 90% US silver coins. And that means that whatever you have, you know, a half, be it a half, 90% half dollar, dime, quarter, whatever, roughly 12 to 14 times face, you know, maybe a little more than that, depending upon the condition of the coins. But so, for instance, a pre-65 Roosevelt dime or Mercury dime, you know, approximately $1.40 to $1.20, somewhere around there. You know, just 14 times face value, 12 to 14 times face value. Now, some of the coins, like this Morgan dollar, unless it's a cull, you're going to pay more for that because it has numismatic value. Okay, and depending upon the date and so forth. But if it is junk silver, 90% junk silver, it's between 12 and 14 times face. Go to Coinflation to check out the actual price. You know, I'm seeing these lots go for huge amounts of money, way over its bullion value. And generally, you can get 1 ounce bars or rounds. If you can get them, you know, from about a dollar over spot, you'll get more silver, actual silver, from pure bullion than you will from 90% junk silver, but you don't have the numismatic protection that you have with 90% junk silver. There is still some numismatic value, and they'll pay a slight premium for that. And if silver does go down, they tend to hold a little more of their value. You know, even when silver was around $11, $12 an ounce for a while, mercury dimes were still going for about 12 times face. So, you know, they do hold their value pretty well. They're not a bad investment, and I do have a lot of 90% that I like and that I've invested in over the years. But just be careful what you're buying. Read the fine print. Know that the war nickels, the war years, they're 35%. Kennedy's from 65 to 70 are only 40%. So, you know, they're very tricky about the titles that they're putting up. And find out if it's avoirdupois ounces or pounds or troy ounces or pounds, because it makes a huge difference. And then if you really want to know the premium you're paying, go to coinflation.com, look up the weight and the value of each one, and do the math, and it'll give you a good idea of how much of a premium you're paying. So anyway, shop smart. Don't be lazy like I am sometimes. You guys take care. I'll talk to you later. Don't forget to subscribe. Bye now.